So for those of you that are familiar with my channel, you know that quite a few of my videos are about treadmills and treadmill parts. And because of that, I have gotten a lot of comments asking questions about things they've seen in my videos and other parts of treadmills, that kind of thing. And so this is just going to be a video to go over some of those frequently asked questions.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
I get this question a lot, and that is, do I need to use the flywheel that comes with the motor? Maybe. It really depends on your setup. It depends on if you want that extra mass for kinetic energy. It depends on if you can easily modify things to fit the pulley you do want to run onto your motor. And it also depends on how your motor flywheel setup is designed. So this is just a flywheel. That's its only purpose in life, other than the fact that it was a pulley on this end. This one is also the cooling fan. So the motor that this came off of had its own cooling fan. This is also the cooling fan. So in a situation like this, either you have to replace this with a cooling fan or you have to run it. Those are the only two options. On a unit like this one, you can remove it and put whatever pulley you want on there without issues. Now, there's a couple of different ways that these mount. This one uses a key and then set screws, where this one threads on. That makes hooking up other pulleys somewhat challenging because the shaft for this motor is threaded. So how do I end up adding a different pulley to it? I ran into this problem when I upgraded the motor on my mill, and it was really a pretty simple fix. I chucked this up in the lathe and removed all of this grooving for the belt. And then I was able to size it up so that I could press a traditional V pulley over the top so that I still was able to retain the flywheel, retain the cooling fan part of the flywheel, but be able to use the pulley that I wanted. The other thing that's important to know, if you have a thread-on flywheel, especially on smaller motors like the one in my hand, they are oftentimes Loctited in place. And the only way to get them loose is to apply heat. So you can see maybe on there a little bit of discoloration where I hit that with a torch. And after getting it fairly hot, I was able to spin it off.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.